Hello everyone! Today we're going to talk about one of the most memorable cases that you will encounter in law school. We are going to discuss the case of Chi Ming Tsui versus Court of Appeals and Gina Lau Tsui. This case refers to the characteristics of psychological incapacity in Article 36 of the Family Code. In this case, Gina Lau married Chi Ming Tsui sometime on May 22, 1988. After the celebration of their marriage and wedding reception, they went and proceeded to the house of Chi Ming Tsui's mother. Unfortunately, there was no sexual intercourse between them during the first night. The same thing happened in the second, third, and fourth nights. In an effort to have their honeymoon in a private place where they can enjoy together during their first week as husband and wife, they went to Baguio City. But they did so together with her mother, an uncle, his mother, and his nephew. They were all invited by Chi Ming Tsui to join them. They stayed in Baguio City for 4 days. But during this period, there was no sexual intercourse between them. They slept together in the same room and on the same bed since May 22, 1988 until March 15, 1989. But during this period, there was no attempt of sexual intercourse between them. Gina Lau submitted herself to a physical examination, which yielded a result that she is still a virgin. So what is the issue here? The issue here is whether the refusal of Chi Ming Tsui to have sexual communion with Gina Lau is psychological incapacity. What did the Supreme Court say? According to the Supreme Court, the refusal of Chi Ming Tsui to have sexual communion with Gina Lau is psychological incapacity. The Supreme Court finds such abnormal reluctance or unwillingness to consummate his marriage is strongly indicative of a serious personality disorder, which clearly demonstrates an utter insensitivity or inability to give meaning and significance to the marriage within the meaning of Article 36 of the Family Code. His senseless and protracted refusal is equivalent to psychological incapacity. Thus, the prolonged refusal of a spouse to have sexual intercourse with his or her spouse is considered a sign of psychological incapacity. Evidently, one of the essential marital obligations under the Family Code is to procreate children, based on the universal principle that procreation of children through sexual cooperation is the basic end of marriage. Constant non-fulfillment of this obligation will finally destroy the integrity or wholeness of the marriage. Please help us create more videos by hitting the like button and subscribing to our channel. Thank you!